Climate change. What does it look like? In Alaska's Bering Sea and Arctic coast, the challenges are not on some future horizon. They're here and now. People and animals living at the edge of the continent are living at the leading edge of change itself.
The Arctic is a place that is essentially a harbinger of what's to come. The changes in the Arctic have always been predicted to be the first, the most dramatic, the fastest. And that's because of the way the world climate systems are put together. And so what it means is that the changes that we're seeing up here in the Arctic mean that there's going to be changes down in southern latitudes. They're likely to be just as dramatic in those ecosystems and just as important for the people that live in them. We just happen to be seeing dramatic impacts first. And so the challenges that we face today in the Arctic are just a forecast of challenges and difficulties that people in southern latitudes will be facing.
But the picture is complicated by regional differences and, equally important, by variability across time. Understanding timescales and patterns of variability are some of the most important keys to understanding climate change in Alaska and in the world.
Weather is what happens today. If it rains today, that's weather. If it rains for 3 years straight, it's climate. Climate is big. It's not what's happening in your backyard. You know, that's weather. It's a much broader scheme. And so the weather is part of climate because as the climate warms, your weather in the future will probably get warmer too, or it will change. It's more of a smaller scale, a more personal scale. So the Bering Sea is probably going to warm by about 3 degrees in the next 50 years. But that doesn't mean in 50 years it's going to be 3 degrees warmer. You might be on a colder track at that time or a warmer track. It's a variability that occurs on the scale of years as opposed to days. Next year may be a degree colder, and then 3 years later, it may be a degree warmer. And so you have this real pattern of variability. But if you look at the long-term trend, neglecting all this kind of year-to-year variability, in 2030 or 2050, conditions are, in all likelihood, on some average of several years, it's going to be warmer than it is now.
Despite annual variations, the extent of monthly sea ice in the Arctic has shown a strong downward trend over the last several decades. The Bering Sea is a different environment. Instead of multi-year ice, the ice is reformed each fall. The timing is critical to the animal life that lives here. In the Arctic, there was extreme summer sea ice loss recorded in September of 2007, 2008, and 2009. But in the Bering Sea, those same years have produced more than usual ice, a cold phase that is expected to fluctuate, but which demonstrates the geographical as well as the timescale complexity that is part of Alaska's connected ecosystems. Even with these caveats, as you'll see in these next video installments, researchers and residents agree that they are observing conditions they have not seen before. In Life on the Ice, you'll encounter birds, mammals, and other forms of life that thrive in the north and rely on an icy environment for both shelter and food supplies. In Disappearing Sea Ice, you'll meet people who see and experience climate change in all its complexity and uncertainty firsthand.
At Koyuk, freeze up starts around September, October, and then May and maybe first part of June is when the period of time when the ice is there. But we're seeing a lot less of the ice, and the thickness of the ice has changed, and the movement of ice on the ocean is a lot more than, it doesn't stay stable anymore as much as it used to. Now there's a lot of times when the bay is open Right now it's a little different this year. I guess as years go, we see different changes and we adapt to them.